Today I'm going to be doing a little bit of light work on this camera. It's in really good shape for its age, all things considered, but I ran my first roll of film through it and noticed that all of the outdoor shots I took have really low contrast, and it appears that the lens has some haze in it, so that when the sun hits it, it kind of lights up everything, and that really kills the contrast. So I'm going to be taking that apart to clean the lens elements. I'm going to start off by making sure that this is at infinity, and because that's a point that I know I can come back to. All right, well, maybe we'll start by unscrewing these three. Let's see what that freed up. Okay, so this ring is free now, but the focusing knob is still holding in, and actually it looks like the front element's maybe still holding it in too. Let's try taking off the focusing knob. Smaller bit. And that's got a little notch in it to engage it with those. It's got two of them. Probably doesn't matter which way it goes in. Set that aside. Okay, this is free, except it's held in by the front element still. I'm not sure how to get that off just yet. Oh, there's little fiendishly tiny screws around the rim. That might be part of it. Sure that I'm at infinity. Okay, I am. Man, that is a very, very small screw. Hopefully I can just loosen those and it should come off. It looks like they're the type that just are kind of hugging the lens. Yep. focus on them some more. Those are all pretty loose now. Go. Excellent. There's a helpful little mark that somebody, maybe even the factory, made on the lens at the infinity point. So that's very helpful. Alright. Keep that in mind. Now, this comes right off. This doesn't have any mechanisms in it at all. It's just a faceplate. See the gearing for front element. Not sure you need to take that off. All right. That's one full rotation. That's a second full rotation, and off it comes. Okay, so I need to remember that. So that goes back in exactly the right way. One. And that's two. And that means it'll be focused correctly. Make sure these gears don't get out of whack either. And there's the front cell. Where's my light? The haze on this one doesn't seem too bad. There's probably a little bit though. And inside there are two more cells. I'm trying to think how to remove this next cell. This whole thing might just come out, actually. That's on pretty tight. Let's see, I've got some clamps here. Oh, those are too small. Oof, man, that's really, really on tight. Oh, there we go. Seven, eight, four, eight, three. That's what's printed on there. You can see that. serial number for just that cell, maybe. How's the haze on this one? Yeah, not great. And then, finally, the rear cell. I have to get it from the back. That's where I'll probably have to remove the retaining rings from the back. Okay, so here's where I would get at the shutter if I wanted to, but it's still got these rangefinder parts on top of it, and I don't really want to mess with those. Now, interesting, this gear here is the is part of the mechanism that prevents you from firing the shutter until you've actually cocked the shutter, tensioned it. So in all the modes except bulb. So here at bulb, it actually opens the thing, because this shutter is kind of neat. Unlike most shutters, you actually have to cock it for bulb. This one you don't. You just open it. But all the other settings, it needs to be cocked. So like for 1 second. Now you can take it. So if I'm going to get at the shutter, I'd have to remove all of this stuff. I'm not sure I actually want to do that. I might just leave it alone. It was fairly easy to get to this point, so if I ever do have problems with the shutter speeds getting worse and worse, I can get back at it again. So yeah, leave this alone for now. Alright, I need to go get my lens cleaning solution. Okay, I'm back. One thing I realized is if I'm going to get at the rear cell, I need to remove all this stuff. And it'll be much easier if it's all together when I do that. So I quick reassembled everything. And yeah, I'm going to remove the whole thing by taking off the retaining rings in the back. This is easier to do if I fold it first, so I'll do that. So fold it, pop the back open, and now I can get at the retaining rings. And I've got my spanner. And we'll just unscrew this, being, of course, very, very careful to not damage the bellows. These bellows are in great shape, and I'd like them to stay that way. Oh wow, that's actually very loose. That's very loose. Okay, nice. Some like residue in there. I'm gonna clean that up while I'm in there. Now, if I really wanted to, I could probably use the spanner and get at that rear cell right away, but I don't know, it's really tight fit. Probably easier to just take the thing off. So let's do that. Interesting. There's like a bit of a spacer down there. I'm not sure what's up with that. Hmm. Seems like it's a bit of a shim. Oh, I see, it slats in. Okay, alright. Does this come free? No, it doesn't. It's bolted into place. Interesting. What's holding this in? Oh, maybe just the rear cell's holding it in. That could be. Okay, let's let me remove this thing so it's not rattling around. And I'm gonna try just twisting this guy off. Oh, it's really hard to get at. I don't see any other screws that are actually attaching this thing. Folding it back up. Let's see if it. Oh man, that thing just swings right out of the way. Actually, if I do this, it gives me a little more access. Oh, there we go. Ta-da! Oh, it's not even the rear cell, it's just a retaining ring. Just a really, really big one. Yeah. Okay. Now it comes right off. Just like that. Watch out. Oh, there's the shims. Okay, so those have to stay there. Those are important. I'm just going to leave the shims all like that. And then there's our rear cell. Sorry, I'm bringing this all out of focus. And the camera probably can't see any what I'm doing. Careful, because this isn't held in by very much. I don't want to disturb that too much. There we go. Rear cell. Perfect. Rear cell, and I need to get back at the front ones. screws back in, just hold this thing together. Screwed in one of these for some reason. And they keep slipping off. There we go. It should be out far enough now. And off it comes. My infinity mark's still lined up, and it is. Okay. Pop this off. Another thing I noticed is there's these marks here from somebody's screwdriver. Make sure they all line up together. I'm going to not move any of this. Okay. This should require two full turns to come off. One turn, two turns, front cell. And finally, middle cell. Cleaning. Take a clean cotton swab. And I've got some of these Tiffin lens cleaning papers. Just take one out. Blow this thing off first. Oh shoot, where's my bulb? Make sure there's no dust or anything on this. Thank you.
blown clean because it's been on the outside. Still see little specks of dust on there. Got a lint-free brush. This one looks like it's getting a lot of schmoo off, actually. It looks considerably cleaner now. Done. Another sheet. Surface doesn't look as bad. I don't actually know which surfaces have the haze on it. It could be just that outside one. But we're gonna do them all while it's open like this. Thank you. certainly dirty. Yeah, I can actually even see it under this light. Rub in a circular fashion, that way if you are unlucky and get some grit on the Q-tip and it scratches the lens, you want your scratches to be circles if possible. That way they won't impact the image as much. A little better, maybe? Actually, I'll try to do this again. Looks like there's still some schmoo on it. Take one more go at that front.
Alright, let's commence reassembly.
Okay. Inner element. Or middle group, rather. Be careful not to cross thread these. This brass is very soft. Careful not to cross thread these. It just wants to cross thread so badly. And while I'm doing that, this gear wants to come out. Turn. Well, I didn't get it right. There must be multiple ways to thread this on. It's got to start here. No, when all these little things line up just right. It is actually a little bit off. Okay. Bingo. Tighten these screws down. There's one. There's two. Back. This is the wrong screwdriver for this one. I'm just gonna get it. Medium tight, I'll take it up later. That looks like it's all nice and together. And everything rotates as it should. Beautiful. Alright. Oops, I almost dropped the rear element. The rear cell. This one's nice and easy. It doesn't have to be particularly lined up. All back in the camera. Because you gotta get this lined up with all the spacers and whatnot. I'm actually just going to put these on. Somehow. Oh no. Oh boy, this is gonna be tricky. This isn't engaging correctly. Seems like it's doing better now. Thank you. Okay, that's pretty tight. Make sure it doesn't come back out. And everything's lined up, and it does look correct. Make sure there's no light leaks in there. This is firmly attached, and it does look like it is. Hopefully that was a success. We'll have to test it and find out.